Vendor Dan Sheridan Show.
I give you one job.
Hey, Duke.
Poke that timer.
Duke.
The
yep.
Duke.
Yeah. Thanks. Yeah, I know. Well, it's good to have you back, too. Duke missed me while I was gone last week. So.
Yeah, I know. He was nice to me, but I could tell that it wasn't the same for him because you weren't here. You're about the same size as the Duke.
Not really.
Well,
by the way, for our new listeners in Pennsylvania, Nebraska, New Mexico, Duke is our engineer here. He's 6'8". 320 pounds. He thinks he's all right. You are tough, dude.
Yeah, watch it. Yeah.
What? Oh, he wants to know. Speaking of free will, he wanted to know if you had that book with you, your free will book. He hates it.
He hates it.
Of course he does.
How could he? This is the most brilliant book ever written on
the topic. Well, we have an engineer who agrees with us so much that during our show, he sits there and he watches a game and eats a Euro or something.
Yeah, he watches baseball on his black and white television.
Do you have your book on free will?
He did like our analogy, though, about the pitchers.
I don't know. Did he?
Well, I'm assuming.
He didn't say anything to me.
Well, I guess it is kind of disconcerting.
Yeah.
His silence is very disconcerting.
So you have your book?
Yes, I do. I wrote a book called The Really Bad Thing About Free Will. We've teased our listeners long enough. We should define Calvinism, Arminianism, and the other ism you mentioned. What was that other ism you mentioned? That was dispensationalism. Horrible term. I divorce myself from any ism. What the heck is that? Santa Claus coming to town?
Hold on.
Who is he?
Hello?
You're supposed to turn your phone off during the show.
Great, I'm in the studio. It's Billy Graham.
You're kidding me.
We're in the middle of a recording, Mr. Graham. Did you hear? You heard it?
Oh, jeez.
Billy Graham, while I talk to
no.
you, pick up the phone,
oh,
please.
Crap.
Pick up the phone. Yeah, we're on the air, sir.
Hello?
Yeah.
Is this really Billy? This isn't really Billy Graham, is it? It is? Okay. How you're not feeling too good? Yeah. So you did say that. That's what I thought. I was taught you did say that.
Wow.
You actually tell people not to pray for the people come, right? I know. Well, I appreciate your honesty,
well,
sir.
Well, get Billy's address. We'll send him your book on free will.
Would you be interested in... Hello?
He hung up, didn't he?
He hung up.
Yeah.
But he did say it.
He did say it.
He did say it. That's
nice.
All he wanted to say, I guess. He didn't want to hear about my stupid book. I mean, my brilliant book.
Yeah, your brilliant, stupid book.
The Really Bad Thing About Free Will. There's a subtitle to this book.
What's it called?
It's called A Critical Look at the Salvation by Willpower Doctrine. Because
okay.
I stripped this thing to its essence, you see. It's Salvation by Willpower.
Yeah. How did they get a copy of this book, our listeners?
You win the lottery, baby.
Well, beside that.
Oh, you can go to martinzender.com, or you can go to a bookstore and request it. They could probably get it because this is in the system, baby. We're talking amazon.com. You can get it. But
the really bad thing about free
will. The really bad thing about free will, and it's really bad. I call it the Salvation by Willpower Doctrine because that strips it of its sheep's clothing and reveals the wolf beneath. And it is salvation by willpower. And as much as people don't like to hear that, that's what it boils down to. You save yourself by believing in Jesus Christ.
Mm.
Of course, it's not.
However, we do have to be clear.
We do? For the first time, we're going to be clear.
The scriptures do talk about believing, right?
Yes.
It's also believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. We're justified gratuitously by God's grace. You know, it says... you know, through the deliverance, which is in Christ Jesus. Yet Paul says we believe this message, something that's to be believed. To him that does not work, but believes on him that justifies the ungodly, his faith is counted for righteousness. What we're saying, we acknowledge that the scriptures tell us to believe. But what we're saying, back behind all of that, is God. Believing is not an act that we do, and it's not something that comes from our own willpower. God, you know, Christians, you know, it's interesting, you talk about inconsistency. I always talk about, well, it's the Spirit moving within me when they talk about doing things, right?
Yeah.
How come they never say that about their salvation? Isn't that true of their salvation?
I think they'll say it. It's the Spirit moving in me. But my question is, what's the source of that Spirit?
It's God. That's the point. And it all comes back to God.
But look what happens when you say that. If it all comes back to God, and it takes the Spirit of God for somebody to say, I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, then why does God give that to one person and not to another person? If it truly is all of God, then God could give it to everybody.
Okay.
And now we're getting into...
Is that the question? Why does God give it to some and not to others?
That could be the question. Let's make it the question.
Is that what you want to discuss? Why does God give it to some and not to others?
Yes, because that will lead us finally into defining Calvinism.
Okay.
And those other horrible isms. And I will be able to quote from my brilliant book on this topic.
Okay, well, since, you know, you're the brains of this operation, why don't you start? I'll ask you the question. Right. Mr. Zender?
Yes.
Excuse me, Professor Dr. PhD Zender?
Yes, speaking.
Why does God choose to save some and not others, sir? Hmm?
He doesn't. He doesn't. That's what the Calvinists believe. Now, let me tell you a little bit about Calvinism. Calvinists are people who belong to a religion invented by John Calvin. Might not be a religion, but
You say the word John Calvin, will you say it with a little more reverence, please? Thank you.
Okay, let me try it again. Calvinists are people who belong to a religion invented by John Calvin.
Okay, go ahead.
John Calvin did see the truth of the sovereignty of God.
Ah, yes.
I'll give him credit where credit is due. He acknowledged that members of Christ's body are predestined for it long before they were born, and it comes wholly apart from human merit.
Good, good.
As
excellent.
As you like to say,
wonderful.
It is not out of you. Ephesians 2:8-9. Salvation
Love
is
it.
Not out
Love
of you.
It.
Love it.
Me and John and God agree.
Well, I'm sure God is happy to hear that.
I'm sure.
That you're on his side.
Yeah, go ahead.
People are designated beforehand. Give me a verse on that, Mr. Know Everything.